Danny Mac, now I can hear ourselves. Let's run down the rosters real quick. And Dan, this is the only postseason game or the only playoff and tournament here that doesn't feature an international squad, so all based out of the mainland 48 states, if you would. So going down Blue Ridge's roster from the 55-ranked Blue Ridge Roller Girls, the 7 seed coming in, we've got number 00, Brutal, 033, Princess Suck It Up, Buttercup, 10, Ash Villain, 1081, Dixie Kicks, 1138, Hopiwan, 13, Poca Hot Mess, 155, Hurricane Jackie, 315, Coma Inducer, 36, Boot Scoot and Bully, number 5, Lady Rider, 505, Distressa, 6, Tractor Taylor, and 88, Dr. Octopushy, and 917, Vexing Violet. Blue Ridge Roller Girls are coached by Centaur of Attention and Chief Goober.
And for Carolina, they are 10th seed in this tournament. They're number 62 ranked overall from Raleigh, North Carolina. So a North Carolina tilt going on here in Kansas. They'll start with number 10, D&T Christ. Also, Electrocution, number 121. You got 21 is Crankdat. 301 is Dot Bomber. JoJo Gadget wears number 313. Number 33 is Grim Carry. Number 34, Mako Gori. Number 42 is Ava Gore. Number 47 is Critical Aaron. 7, Aurora Thunder. 750 is Fanny Pack-a-Punch. 86, Ginger Clobbers. And The Ish wears number 88.
And actually, Danny Mack, interesting storyline here. I did not see JoJo Gadget. I know she was flying in this morning. You got in at 3:30 this morning, which was I considered cutting it close if we had to be here an 8 a.m. call time for us. But JoJo Gadget was landing this morning and was supposed to come straight to the venue. I have not seen her at warm-ups. I have not seen her on the track unless she just slid in during the national anthem. JoJo Gadget still not here for Carolina. I'm looking at the bench, and I still do not see JoJo.
And that's a big scoring punch, potential scoring punch that Carolina would be missing without JoJo Gadget. As we look ahead, this is the 7-10 matchup. This is where it gets really interesting. A lot of tournaments, you'll see that opening game be sort of a throwaway. That's not the case in Division II when the 10 and the 7 face each other. And this morning, we've got a dandy. As we said, it's a rivalry among these two teams, and they've played each other four times overall, with Blue Ridge coming out victorious more often than not, 3-1 in that category. But looking back at Carolina's season, this is a team that is 4-5 overall. Most of their wins came at the very beginning of the season. They cranked off three straight victories to start. That was in the K-Town Shakedown, Grand Ragony, Kalamazoo, and Brew City. Followed that up with the losses to Ohio and Ann Arbor later, a couple weeks later. So a fireball start to a season, and they've sort of played a little back and forth, losing to some very good teams toward the end of the season, Windy City and Cincinnati, playoff teams at the very end.
Yeah, and as a coach, you know, you really kind of want to schedule those games there near the end of the season, kind of ramp yourself into playoffs. You don't want to take off that month or whatever once the final rankings come out going into the postseason. Mm-hmm. But, you know, you certainly don't want to go 0-3 going into the end of the playoffs location. You want some momentum. That kind of comes with scheduling and things like that. But like you said, yeah, starting off 7-0 did did Blue Ridge. And then finishing off 0-3 going with their loss to Ann Arbor, Naptown, and Sydney. And Sydney's an up-and-coming thing. They just beat Sun State at the Great Southern Slam down in Alabama. A little further south and a little further east, Australia. Well, you were talking about the 7-10 upset, Danny Mac. 50% of the games in division, 50% a toss-up, literally, depending on who wins the 7-10 matchup here on opening days since this new postseason, since the new playoff structure came in place. Thanks, Dylan Powell, for those stats.
And as we look at the history of these two teams in the playoffs, Blue Ridge returning. They didn't make it last season. They're back in 2013. They finished third place in D2, one of the great stories, one of the great surprise and beginning stories of that tournament, where we didn't know a whole heck of a lot of Blue Ridge coming in, having joined the WFTDA in 2012, making the playoffs 2013, and really showing up well the next season making Division One, getting 10th place there in Sacramento. Again, missing this season, so they're back in this one. They're back in the playoff hunt and looking to, again, continue to show some people up and from that 7 seed look to even improve.
Yeah, they've had about a great a start for a league as you can have. You know, if you're an upstart league and, you know, you're just kind of like coming into things, just got your sanctioning status through the Wftda, look at Blue Ridge and how they did it. Like you said, you know, they came in the very next year, third place D2. Then they bumped up into D1. They went 0-3 at that D1 playoffs. But this is a team that set themselves up right for success right off the bat, and that's how teams really should do it. They did a really good job.
Yeah, and that is extremely difficult to do. On the other hand, Carolina has been out of the playoffs the last two seasons. They were a perennial team that would make that postseason play. And as we go as far back as 2006 championships, where they lost in the quarterfinals. Now, that was determined in a much different way. That was almost an invite type of situation for teams. They're an original member of the WFTDA. They have a lot of history, as we said, from Raleigh, North Carolina, and a team that started off with 3 wins has since gone 4-5 to finish things out. But their last playoff appearance, a 7th place finish in Division II, that was in Kalamazoo, Michigan.
We've got about 45 seconds here, and Danny Mac, I really think the story of this game is going to be penalties. You know, like I said, these two teams, out of all the teams here at Wichita, are the most familiar with each other. Like you said, they've played each other 4 times coming into this bout. They're from the same state of North Carolina. They know each other. They know what each other's strengths and weaknesses are. It's up to these individual teams now, Blue Ridge and Carolina, to play their best games to advance to the 4 o'clock game today, where they'll play Houston Roller Derby, the number 2 seed. Looking at the, kind of statistics from this season, Blue Ridge leads almost in all categories against Carolina. Their jammers only average 6.8 jammer penalties about. That's compared to 7.3 for Carolina. Blocker penalties, 22.4 blocker penalties a game for the Blue Ridge Roller Girls, compared to almost 31 for Carolina.
And the first whistle gets players set. That sort of settled things. On the jammer line for Blue Ridge, they're wearing black with teal and white trim. That is Dr. Octopushy, the leading scorer on this Blue Ridge team, the all-star team, wearing number 88. For Carolina will be 86. Ginger Clobbers there in white. And the third leading scorer, rather, on Carolina All-Stars team, lead jammer right out of the gate for Blue Ridge.
Dr. Octopushy, like you said, lead jammer for Blue Ridge. Dr. Octopushy, the only jammer in this playoff location to score over 1,000 points as a jammer.
Dr. Octopushy going to the inside part of the track, calls it off, getting through, and a very quick scoring play there, and not even really allowing the other jammer to get an opportunity to score. She didn't get out of the pack.
Blue Ridge really only features 3 jammers. Dr. Octopushy scoring 1,058 points in this 2016 season. That's through 10 games, so averaging 106 points about. Following her up is Hurricane Jackie with 511 and 449 for Lady Ryder.
Carolina this time running out Fanny Pack-a-Punch, the leading jammer scorer for Carolina. She'll get swallowed up immediately to the inner part of the track and just being pushed around by those black shirts. Her opponent, jammer, is Lady Ryder, the number 3 leading scorer, and Carolina has a lead jammer, their first one, with a minute and a half into this one.
Nice little sidestep toe hop going the outside of turn 2, allowing Lady Ryder to pick up that lead designation.
That's Andrew Marone. I'm Danny Mack. We appreciate you joining us on WFTDA.TV. 1 point for Carolina as they are now on the board. It's 4-1 after 2 jams.
Still no sign of JoJo Gadget for Carolina, so that's going to really hurt Carolina Roller Girls on the defensive side of things. Played in every game so far this year for Carolina, and they're definitely going to miss her in the pack.
Yeah, that's a player that really opens up a lot of holes offensively for this team, and we'll see how they strategize around that. Starting from the behind the jammer line, that was Hurricane Jackie, who will take lead jammer, getting some momentum and cutting straight through the pack. Out and in scoring position for Carolina, that's Ava Gore.
Aurora Thunders did a nice job of knocking Ava Gore out of bounds as the jam gets called off by Ava Gore's 2 points for Blue Ridge.
So 6-1 is the score, 27 minutes, 25 seconds remaining. It's the first period of two 30-minute periods of roller derby here from the Wichita Sports Forum.
If you've got something to say to us, talk to hashtag talk to WFTDA on Twitter.
Familiar jammers run out here. This was what they started the bout with. This is Dr. Octopushy for Blue Ridge and Ginger Clobbers going for Carolina. Clobbers heads to the outside and gets almost single-handedly pushed back in. Blue Ridge trying to contain the jammer up front.
Direction of gameplay penalty being assessed to Deante Christ for Carolina. 4-3 pack advantage now for Blue Ridge as Blue Ridge Pushy obtains lead designation once again.
And we were watching some isolation play going on there by the Blue Ridge blockers.
Fantastic job by Hopi Wan knocking the Carolina jammer out of bounds on the back straightaway as there is JoJo Gadget. She is in the game, so I did not see her originally. Everyone at home probably screaming. She's wearing the only one wearing the red helmet, Marone. So she is here, did make it on time. Great to see that.
Good to see. And again, going right after the opposing jammer, immediately making her impact felt.
The boarding pass still falling out of her pocket.
5 points on the board for Blue Ridge. That makes it 11-1 over Carolina. Blue Ridge the 7 seed, Carolina the 10 seed in D2 in Wichita.
And we do have a power jam now to Blue Ridge as the jammer Ginger Clobbers is seated in the penalty box.
There goes Dr. Octopushy. Got knocked to the inside of the track. We'll have to reset. Not necessarily by the player that blocked her out of bounds, but sometimes teams will throw a player back there as almost a decoy, making you think, hey, I've got to reset behind the farthest blocker. So that's what they did. Dr. Octopushy now has company as Ginger Clobbers has returned to the floor.
That is, I believe that's actually Aurora Thunder. I believe she was the pivot star pass.
It is.
So Aurora Thunder now the jammer of note for Carolina. She is replaced by JoJo Gadget, who got a blocking out of bounds penalty on the jammer pushy for Blue Ridge.
Score currently 21-1. And we are about 5 minutes into bout one of the 2016 International WFTDA playoffs.
Right now, Blue Ridge exemplifying the precision meets performance standard as set forth by the Rydell family. Quick, we need to roll out quick, think quick, quick bearings. Roll faster, further, and smoother with precision bearings from Quick.
Fanny Pack-a-Punch going to the inside for Carolina. Blue Ridge choosing an outside route. They'll run with Lady Rider.
High block to Fanny Pack-a-Punch now, so a second power jam in favor of the Blue Ridge Roller Girls.
Blue Ridge making haste to get their jammer out and in scoring position. Blue Ridge with an opportunity to blow it out, blow it up even farther early in period one. Lady Rider gets dragged back, this time by Crank Dad. And we'll have to reset and recharge. Nice penalty kill by Carolina.
Aurora Thunder, I'm sorry, Fanny Pack-a-Punch now out of the Triple Eight penalty box. Still on there is her initial pass as we have a grand slam being put on the board for Ryder of Blue Ridge.
Ryder already back up on the pack as it had slowed down to a crawl. Blue Ridge, again, isolating on that Carolina jammer, pushing them to one side or the other and allowing a lane for their own jammer. Ryder 5 more, make it 31-1, a 30-point lead for Blue Ridge, 7 minutes in.
Trying to play a little offense for her, jammer was cranked at for Carolina, picks up a forearm in the process, and now we have a cutting the track call again on Fanny Pack-a-Punch, her second trip to the Triple Eight penalty box, still on her initial pass, still Danny Mack.
25 seconds left in this jam, Blue Ridge trying to score and score quickly.
At 15 points now.
Wrist whip around the outside for 4 more points. Blue Ridge, 40-1, the current score. Blue Ridge is tearing it apart. Jammer penalties playing a big role in that, but not the only role.
So far, clean penalty board for Blue Ridge.
Hurricane Jackie jamming for Blue Ridge. Jamming unopposed at the moment. Number two leading scorer on Blue Ridge All-Stars. Hurricane Jackie, one player to beat, and then gets swallowed back up. Carolina returns another shirt. Water falling toward the front of the pack, and a lead jammer for Blue Ridge. Just then, Fanny Pack-a-Punch returns for Carolina.
And I believe we have a star pass now to Crankdat. Can't risk the third jammer penalty, Danny Mack, for Fanny Pack-a-Punch, so Crankdat, now the jammer of note for Carolina Rollergirls.
Hurricane Jackie doing what Hurricane Jackie does. Now going outside, gets swallowed at the rear of the pack. And the star pass is complete. And until that cover goes on the pivot helmet, it's a no scoring position as Crankdat came up near the rear of the pack. Jackie saw that, stopped it with 3 points more on the board for Blue Ridge. 47-1.
Things are getting a little colorful here, Danny Mack, but not as colorful as Adam Skates. Adam Skates, hashtag color me Adam. Color Falcon plates and color Q for boots. Check them all out, the colors. New goods from Adam Skates.
The Ish going in white for Carolina. Dr. Octopushy going in black for Blue Ridge. The Ish. Got trapped on the middle part of the track, allowing Dr. Octopushy to go through untouched on the right side.
So far, Blue Ridge exemplifying a strategy here off the jam start. They've only not obtained lead status once, Danny Mack.
They've done it. We've said it already by singling out the opposing jammer, taking care of them, and giving a lane, sometimes in, sometimes out, to their own jammer. Dr. Octopushy, 52-1 is Blue Ridge's lead with 10 minutes remaining in the first period, or 10 minutes gone in the first period. Another grand slam.
Oh, the Ish with a nice little 360 spin coming out of turn three. Puts the cap back on her head. Ish, not a typical jammer for Carolina. Has only jammed 10 times. I'm sorry. Yeah, has only jammed 10 times this season for Carolina. Has only averaging less than 3 points a time they jam.
Blue Ridge continues to pile up the points, but the Ish has gotten through for four.
And it looks like they're running this as 4 points for the Ish, like you said, Danny Mack. So.
61-5 the current score, 19 minutes and 30 seconds or so remaining in the first period. We're grateful for you joining us here on WFTDA, if it's by the free audio stream or if you have joined us on TV, we appreciate you. The entire VIP package for tickets, those are on sale. Be a champion VIP, get your VIP tickets to champs. That's $125, that gets you reserved seating. Best seats in the house, a collector's program and a VIP badge. That's for championships, $125.
Both jammers so far right off the jam start knocked out of bounds, both the respective sidelines. Both still trying to make their way through the initial pass and lead designation going to Blue Ridge's Lady Rider.
Lady Rider's been dominant so far.
3 for 3.
She'll get some static on the inside of the track by the pivot. That's Aurora Thunder. We saw Aurora Thunder receive the star earlier. Both players are now able to score, both jammers that is, able to score on the track. That's Ava Gore that had gotten through. And 5 more points for Blue Ridge. 69-5 is the current score, 18 minutes remaining in the first.
Like we said earlier, Carolina Roller Girls, one of the original WFTDA members, almost around just as long, are Fast Girl Skates. Fast Girl Skates, 9 years dedicated to making a faster you. Thank you, Fast Girl Skates.
different strategies to start this one. Blue Ridge started their jammer a few steps back. Hurricane Jackie, she likes to get that lead start and will get sent out for blocking in the back. As soon as she hits, she'll have 30 seconds to think about it. Lead jammer for Carolina. Power jam and a chance to get back in this one, trailing by 64.
It was off that initial surge off the jam start line. Did hurry pick up that blocking to the back penalty for Blue Ridge. So now a great opportunity for Carolina to get things moving in the right direction if they're going to close this 64-point gap that Blue Ridge has amassed within the first 13 minutes of the contest.
Ginger Clobbers. A two-wall, a very friendly two-wall, friendly to themselves, not to their foe, is Blue Ridge, and completely stifling this penalty.
Well, and here's the thing. Carolina keeps scooting up, so they're keeping their jammer in play at the front of the pack. If Carolina had stayed where they are, the foremost two blockers for Blue Ridge, Jordy Danny Mack, would have been out of play, and that would have sprung Ginger Clobbers from the pack.
Clobbers still stuck and got through that time as Carolina seemed to get the memo at the very end, turned around, and began to free their own jammer. Five more points for Carolina total on that one. A five-point jam, I would call that a victory for Blue Ridge as well, to have a jammer penalty and hold a very prolific scorer in Clobbers down to 5 points. Blue Ridge seeming to focus much more on isolating the jammer and taking them out of the action before they can even make a play. On the right side goes Blue Ridge, barreling through, and lead jammer.
First time we've seen Tractor Taylor take the star for Blue Ridge.
Tractor Taylor now at the rear part of the pack. Got through three Carolina blockers and passed the jammer for 5 points.
4-3 pack advantage two for Blue Ridge as the pivot for Carolina is seated in the penalty box. Oh, and we have some contact after the whistle. JoJo looking up at the jam ref, asking for a little clarification of why that wasn't a late hit, but it doesn't look like she's going to get it. 74-10 in favor of Blue Ridge after that 5-point jam by Trax.
Trax came barreling in. 88's on the line for their respective squads as the ish going for Carolina facing Dr. Octopushy for Blue Ridge.
Blue Ridge started this game going Dr. Octopushy, Ryder, and Hurricane Jackie. And kind of over the last five jams, we haven't seen that same rotation. They've been able to get in Tractor Taylor for a jam there and a couple other jammers there. So maybe starting to already space their jammers out. We do know the winner is going to go on to play again at 4 o'clock against Houston Roller Derby, the number 2 seed. The non-winner of today's contest will play later today against, will play tomorrow morning against the loser of Brandywine, Kansas City. So we do have an official timeout now. Can only speculate as to it might have been after a illegal procedure late hit.
And we'll get the official word on that. We're 15 minutes and 1 second in to the first period with Blue Ridge leading 74-10. That's Andrew Marone. I'm Danny Mack. We are grateful for you joining us on WFTDA.TV. We're in the Wichita Sports Forum, the grand opening bout of the 2016 International WFTDA Playoffs. Lead jammer just like that, Blue Ridge.
Dr. Octopushy, 4-for-4 now, obtaining lead designation, and she's finding nothing but seams. And we have a power jam now, Danny Mack, as a cutting the track penalty issued to the ish. And there we're seeing that inexperience in jamming for the ish. Only jammed a handful of times throughout the regular season.
Dr. Octopushy just chomping up track, another fiver. Leading scorer of the bout, she has 46 big ones. Dr. Octopushy now will go to the right side, get called for the track cut.
Oh. A revolving door now going to take place in the 888 penalty boxes. As soon as Pushy sits, the ish will be able to be released. It's almost going to be a full 30 seconds. It looks like it was about 23, 24 seconds there, Danny Mack.
Pretty close. 74-point lead for Blue Ridge. Carolina, there's a lot of time left in this bout with 14 minutes remaining in the first, but they have got to get some scoring immediately, if not sooner. The Ish. Now goes to the right side. That's what they're talking about. 5 points.
Typically a jammer death sentence going around the outside of one of the turns, but she had a nice fake to the inside at turn one to open up the outside of turn two, Danny Mack, enabling her to get that scoring pass.
5 points to match for Blue Ridge. 27 seconds remaining in the jam. The Ish taking the outside route, but again, a three-wall braced holding up the Carolina jammer. This time she deftly maneuvered that one, got to the inside to take her five with Dr. Octopushy matching.
5 seconds left in this jam, plenty of time, enough time for both jammers to score points, and holy cow, around the outside went Pushy for Blue Ridge, picking up all 5 points again.
Quick, athletic move with time ticking down. You don't even have enough time to think about what you're doing, you just have to do it, and Dr. Octopushy likes the results.
Coming into this game, Carolina averages 7.33 jammer penalties about. They've already got four in the first 17 minutes of this contest. So already ahead of schedule, but not on the good side of things, are Carolina and their jammer penalties.
Fanny Pack a Punch jamming for Carolina and Lady Ryder going for Blue Ridge. Lady Ryder has 24 points. Fanny has 1 point.
Nice jammer defense by Carolina there as Fanny Pack-a-Punch. Oh, and it's going to be a cutting the track to Fanny Pack-a-Punch. Fanny Pack-a-Punch knocked Lady Ryder out of bounds, but then stepped back in, but not before a Blue Ridge skater dropped back to force the cut call.
And that's the nature walk. She's got to take that entire way around the track before she sits.
And that's her third penalty too, Danny Mack.
Yikes. Penalties clearly hurting Carolina as we are early in this one. Blue Ridge has breached the century mark and looking for more. Blue Ridge will go to the outside. Carolina not really formed in any particular, I mean, they're trying to line up and guard one side and sort of squeeze in a big hit on the inside part of the track, but just not quite seeing the level of organization from Carolina's team as we've seen from Blue Ridge in terms of pack work.
Right now they're doing pretty well here, Danny Mack, holding the jammer Lady Ryder in at turn four. Nice pendulum swinging defense there off of the brace by JoJo Gadget. Electrocution now knocking the jammer Ryder out of bounds at turn four.
Electrocution really makes this defense and offense tick when she's on the floor.
Pack-a-Punch is released, but still on her initial pass as she collides to, well, the back of everybody coming out of turn four.
And a very pained look on Lady Ryder's face as she got back up from falling to the ground. Getting taken down there, and Ryder appears a little bit slower than when she took that hit.
Oh, nice shot there into turn two by the Blue Ridge contingent as we have a 14-point jam for Blue Ridge.
Five at the end. Makes it 108-19. Blue Ridge over Carolina. The 7 seed beating the 10 seed in Wichita at the moment. 10 minutes, 7 seconds to go in the first period.
Five double-digit jams for Blue Ridge jammers. Jams of 15, 19, 17, 24, and that 10 spot.
Ginger Clobbers will start on the right side right at the jammer line. Hurricane Jackie at typical start a few steps back. Jackie goes to the outside and takes lead jammer. With her team leading 108-19, Clobbers is out. Hurricane Jackie got around one more Carolina player before tapping the hips for a couple of points.
So after a two-jam scoreless drought there for Carolina, two put on the board by Ginger Clobbers. Thank you to S1 Helmets. The S1 Lifer Helmet is the best fitting and safest helmet for roller derby. Get a lifer, be a lifer. S1 Helmets makes the best helmets and pads for roller derby. S1, part of my uniform, stability, function, durability, and superior shock absorbent. Makes the S1 Pro knee pad the best knee pads for roller derby.
The fast girl start line has been active again. But a penalty, a jammer penalty, skating out of bounds was the call at the very end of the play on Blue Ridge. So Carolina will begin with a power jam. Good one-on-one work by Ash Villain, but not enough. As the jammer Ava Gore continues to move around. Ava, nice strafing work, avoiding the block. Took a bit of a hit, but that could have been much worse.
Oh, and an out of play on Ash Villain was called because it looked like she drew the track cut on Ava Gore, but it was just came back in bounds right as that out of play penalty was being assessed. So fortunate two times there for Carolina's jammer Ava Gore.
Bang, bang, play results in the jammer staying on the track. Ava Gore, one player to beat, trying to get around and will be knocked out of bounds. That was Boots Scootin' Bully, taking her out enough to force the call off with 4 points for Blue Ridge.
A 9-0 jam for Carolina, yeah.
Pardon me, yeah, for Carolina, those 4 points at the end.
So just under, well, just about 7.5 minutes remaining here. Carolina starting to get into the swing of things here, Danny Mack, over the last few jams.
Team's trying to mix it up a little bit. Aurora Thunder jamming for Carolina. Tractor Taylor jamming for Blue Ridge. And it's Tractor Taylor taking lead jam.
First time we've seen Aurora Thunder with the star cap in this bout.
Four points for Blue Ridge, and they'll stop it before Carolina can get their jammer near the pack. That one sped up toward the end.
Typically only a blocker, sometimes acts as a pivot, did Aurora Thunder this season. Only has 4 season points for Carolina, and it's going to stay that way as she was shut out there 4-0 by Trax.
Dr. Octopushy for Blue Ridge. Carolina will run out Ginger Clobbers to the fast girl start line. Clobbers goes inside. Dr. Octopushy going right up the gut as Carolina decides to swell around her. Clobbers lead jammer.
First time Clobbers been able to get lead designation for Carolina. Was 0 for 5 up until this point. Now a good job by Carolina. Oh, and we have a star stash for Blue Ridge, but now back on the head for Pushy.
Can sometimes be a confusing play if you're a defender out there. When that jammer removes the helmet cover, they just become another blocker.
And it looked like at the beginning of the surge here, it looked like that Blue Ridge was content to speed things up and allow the clock to run here. But now they're going to run this jam as Ginger Clobbers and both Pushy on a scoring pass.
Clobbers shaking off the cobwebs as she gets up. Big shot delivered at the end of the play. So Clobbers ends up on the ground, but will return to play. 118-37 is the Blue Ridge lead. 5 minutes, 20 seconds to go in this first of 2 30-minute periods.
Danny Mack, who's taking that fast girl start line?
That will be for Carolina. You got Grim Carey jamming for the first time, facing off against Lady Ryder. Ryder's been quite effective, 34 points, the number 2 scorer on the floor, and Ryder getting lead jammer yet again. Getting lead jammer at an 80% clip.
5-point pass for Lady Ryder as she was able to use that braced three wall of her own teammates to kind of form like the old high school basketball, the old picket fence, you know, screen, enabling, you know, the defense couldn't get to the jammer and the jammer just used the other side of the fence.
Don't get caught watching the paint dry, boy.
That's right.
123-37, Blue Ridge up over Carolina. A battle of North Carolina in Wichita.
Blue Ridge's defense stifling up front, and again, the picket fence works to their advantage, whether they're doing it intentionally, Danny Mack, or not, but, you know, just using the side of that screen to get to find themselves room, or to find herself room, is Lady Ryder.
Grimm continues to get worked over.
Outside, inside, Blue Ridge Pack creating space for their jammers.
And just like that, another grand slam. Blue Ridge cruising almost back to a 100-point lead.
We have an empty 888 penalty box. 4-on-4 on the track, two jammers. Still on her initial pass, though, is Grim Carey.
Lady Ryder has 49 points already. And make it more, another five. 54 points total for Blue Ridge via Lady Ryder. When Lady Ryder's out there, her team is outscoring the opponents 48-0.
That jam comes to its natural conclusions as Blue Ridge was able to hold Grim Carey on her initial pass for the entire 2 minutes. Four additional put on the board for Blue Ridge's Ryder. So 142-37 with just under 3 minutes remaining, Danny Mack, in this first period.
That's right. We're getting to a very critical time where Carolina's got to get some points. They're now down over 100 with only a couple of jams remaining in this first period. Carolina will truck out Ava Gore. Blue Ridge will run from a jammer perspective with Hurricane Shacky. A straight wall that will then collapse around the jammer is working at the rear of this very physical pack for Carolina. Carolina's in white. Look at Blue Ridge up front defensively, giving it to the Carolina jammer, but she absorbs the blow and keeps moving. That's Ava Gore.
Ohio played Carolina earlier this season, and what Carolina does off the start, they kind of go into that braced wall right off the jam start, and they morph into that diamond formation. Unfortunately for Carolina so far in this first half, they haven't been able to set up that diamond formation. The constant movement by Blue Ridge and the constant movement by Blue Ridge's jammers is really kind of screwing up that pattern of how to set up ability, I guess, Danny Mack.
Track cut called on Hurricane Jackie. She'd removed the helmet cover. So wasn't actively scoring points at the moment. In fact, she hadn't even gotten out before drawing that track cut. Ava Gore calls it off with a opposing jammer in the box. 5 points for Carolina. They have bridged the lead to 100 with a minute and 11 to go in the first period. Clobbers to the line.
Yeah, it's when Carolina has time and the ability to set up their pack mid-jam, they can be very successful. Unfortunately, Blue Ridge isn't giving them that opportunity yet so far, Danny Mack.
Clobbers has been a stalwart so far, one of the better performing jammers for Carolina, and she immediately takes lead jam.
And we should have mentioned that's Hurricane Jackie's third penalty as well, Danny Mack. So now two jammers, one for each side, Fanny Pack-a-Punch and Hurry for Blue Ridge, both of three.
Stacking them up.
You get seven, you can't take them with you.
Hurricane Jackie, that's always been your motto.
As long as I'm not coaching it, yep. That would drive me nuts.
Hurricane Jackie has returned, and she'll get smothered by four white shirts.
Ginger has been awarded lead.
Another very nice penalty kill by Blue Ridge.
Coma inducer knocking Ginger Clobbers to the outfield of turn three, and Clobbers a little slower and slower the more she gets knocked to the track.
Jackie has removed the helmet cover, has stashed it, got knocked out of bounds, and will take the track cut.
Vish was the one that knocked her out of bounds, but JoJo Gadget was the Carolina skater who dropped back, forcing that track cut. So a fourth penalty now on the Blue Ridge jammer.
And that does it for the first period of play. We'll wait for the official whistles to signal the end, but quick work on that one. Not a whole lot of downtime in the first period, but it was wire to wire for Blue Ridge from the start. I liked what I saw out of Carolina toward the end. They kind of got their house a little bit better in order and got those jammers freed up a little more.
Well, after only getting lead designation 20% of the time over the first 10 jams, they actually closed the half with getting three out of five lead designation. So they may have seen something during that official timeout that was right around that jam 13. Maybe doing a little tinkering there right off the jam start has enabled Carolina's jammers to at least get lead. Now, the second part of that is getting through on scoring passes, but Blue Ridge is doing just simply a fantastic job in the pack when they're able to set.
You mentioned lead percentage, and that was 75% for Ava Gore. She leads all skaters, leads all Carolina skaters in that category. Tractor Taylor, who has jammed twice, has gotten lead jam twice. But the leading scorers so far, you've got Ava Gore at 19, and she has really been a difference maker. 12 points is her differential advantage against Blue Ridge. And for Blue Ridge, their leading scorer is Dr. Octopushy at 64, right behind her, Lady Ryder, 58 points. We've got another 30 minutes of roller derby coming up. It's the International WFTDA Division II playoffs here on WFTDA.tv.
See you in a few.
Welcome back to Wichita. As you just saw, if you want to be a champion, a championship WFTDA championship MVP, check that out. $125 gets you a three-day VIP experience for this year's WFTDA International Championships. That's reserved seating, the best seats in the house. You'll get a championship collector's program, a VIP badge and lanyard, and there are limited amount of these available, so get yours starting Monday, August 22nd, WFTDA.com/champs. If you're viewing us on WFTDA.tv, you already kind of know it, but there are options even for your viewing experience, and one of those is for all seven tournaments, everything all the way up to champs, $75 is all you have to plunk down, and you will get all seven of the tournaments, the Division IIs, Division I, and the championship, all in the palm of your hand wherever you decide to take in the WFTDA action. That's Andrew Marone. I'm Danny Mack. I really appreciate you joining us on WFTDA.tv. We're kicking things off Division II style here in Wichita, and we're seeing a wire-to-wire lead from Blue Ridge over Carolina.
There was an official review there at the end of the first half. The play stands, so nothing's going to be overturned. So, again, you can't take it with you. You might as well use it on the final jam. They did, no call stands there. Going into the kind of a statistic side of things, five jammer penalties for both squads. That's kind of more consequential for Blue Ridge, as they only average about 6.8 per game. So they're already about 1.8 away. You can't have 0.8 of a penalty, Danny Mac, but we'll just call it two just for the sake of argument. But really, those two, they picked up two on the last two jams. Those two picked up by Hurricane Jackie. Hurricane Jackie now is leading all skaters in penalties with four, and she picked up two of those four on that final jam. She's been 3 for 8 on the jam star, went to the box four times with a 11-point production so far. She's the only skater with a negative differential for Blue Ridge with minus 10. On the other side of things, Carolina, all jammers have a negative differential except for Ava Gore, number 42 for Carolina. She's actually plus 12, so we may start seeing a little bit more of Ava Gore. Carolina really only goes with a three-jammer rotation, Danny Mack, but so far they've thrown six skaters out there with the star.
Yeah, they've worked Grim Carrion and the Ish as well. You've got Aurora Thunder grabbing the star one time. Back to the penalties a little bit, Marone. This is, as we look at the total number, that four penalties for Hurry leads all players on the floor. Nobody else on that team has any more than two, and I'm talking about Blue Ridge. They have been extremely clean in this bout. Carolina comes out of the blocks getting lead jammer. That's Ginger Clobbers, who has been very effective, and this is her seventh jam of the bout. She has skated in more jams than any other Carolina jammer.
Oh, and I heard a hard whistle, so that means Ginger Clobber is going to the 888 penalty box for a blocking to the back penalty, and that's going to be a full 30 seconds because right now Hurricane Jackie stands and is now released from the penalty box.
So Hurry will get back on the floor and immediately tackle those white shirts, plowing through the Carolina defense.
Got a direction of gameplay penalty being assessed to a Blue Ridge blocker here, trying to free her jammer, Hurricane Jackie. That is 1081, Hopi Wan.
Sweet spin move by Jackie at the end.
Kicks. Sorry.
Jackie now goes to the outside. One player to beat, and she does.
Good speed on the right side of the track.
This will go the full 2 minutes here, 50 seconds remaining as Hurricane Jackie gets ridden out of bounds by DeAntichrist. Carolina set up nicely now, Danny Mac. Like we said, Owen, it's going to be a penalty now. 2-0, brutal for Blue Ridge. So 4-2 pack advantage for the moment for Carolina.
Another four spot for Carolina. They're in white, Blue Ridge is in black.
Starting to see a little more physical play out of the jammer Ginger Clobbers for Carolina. She lowered the shoulder, threw it right into the chest of the foremost Blue Ridge block and was just pushed all the way from turn one to turn two. But a nice recycling by the ladies in black were able to catch the Ginger Clobbers by the time they got out of turn two.
And then Clobbers got absorbed by those Blue Ridge blockers yet again, being dragged all the way back. 4 points for each at the end of the jam. That's the first jam in period number two. And that sucker went the distance. 151-55, Blue Ridge leading. Their largest lead came at the end of the first period. Up on the line for Carolina, that's Fanny Pack-a-Punch against Dr. Octopushy. And they're going to need a little more production out of Fanny at this point. 1 point so far out of six jams for Carolina.
Used her own teammate as a bulldozer. DeAntichrist did pushy there for Blue Ridge, able to find room, an opportunity to the inside of turn one. Lead designation, Blue Ridge once again.
And the penalty box for Carolina is cranked at the pivot. Another five spot for Dr. Octopushy.
Fanny Pack-a-Punch able to get through as the Blue Ridge Pack kind of dissolved there like a wet paper towel coming into turn three.
Doc Ock takes another four and continues to lead all scorers, racking up 73 points already.
I'd like to give a huge shout out to 5-on-5 Magazine and Moto Skates for partnering up with the WFTDA for this playoff season.
Carolina jammer will be Ginger Clobbers again. Clobbers has been highly effective, especially in the latter half of the first period.
Oh, and here's where the non-resetting is going to hurt Carolina. They've only got two. They're kind of spread out, but a good job by Aurora Thunders and company of knocking Ryder out of bounds to the outfield coming into turn one.
Ryder kind of got caught in her own traffic, or she would have had an open skate. And a track cut called on Carolina. Clobbers will head out, a power jam if Blue Ridge can make it through, and she does. Ryder in scoring position and will have about 30 seconds to try to do damage without another jammer on the floor.
Typically Blue Ridge plays offense for their jammer. In that instance, there was only two Carolina white jerseys up front holding in Lady Ryder. So they said, you know what, we're gonna drop back and play, go old school, play a little passive offense here. Let Ryder do what Ryder does. And she was able to kind of plow stop and get around the hips of both blockers for lead designation.
Ryder just got knocked out of bounds. Grim Carey delivering the big blow. Will draw a penalty after the play. But a nice penalty kill by Carolina. Blue Ridge has a very potent offense, especially on the power jam, and they held Ryder at bay.
Clobbers looking for Crankdat, but Crankdat's now behind Ginger Clobbers in the pack.
Ryder will have to reset. Back behind, you guessed it, Crankdat. Crankdat's been a real pain for this Blue Ridge squad.
15 seconds here, still opportunity for one more scoring pass, possibly for Ryder here in Blue Ridge, already on a 9-0 jam.
169-55 is the score. Blue Ridge has not relinquished the lead the entire bout.
And again, it was Blue Ridge using that walled defense. Like, again, I call it the picket fence. Some of my younger skaters for Ohio look at me like I've got a third arm growing out of my chest because they don't know the reference. But
Hoosiers, darn it. Watch Hoosiers.
Go get Hoosiers, kids.
Right now. Olympians use it to get juiced up.
But again, you know, there's kind of like the conga line, and the jammer goes down to one side, and it's impossible for those Carolina skaters to drop down and attack the jammer.
The Ish jamming for Carolina. That's Tractor Taylor out there for Blue Ridge. Taylor, lead jammer, Blue Ridge.
3 of 4 this period, lead designation going to Blue Ridge. Skaters from Asheville as the Ish gets caught up now behind a triangle brace.
Blue Ridge trying to do what they did in the first period, and that's strike and strike early.
Jam called off just as the fourth whistle blows. Tracks steps back on the track, avoiding the cutting the tracks. Sorry.
If you want to talk to us, the hashtag on Twitter is #talk2WFTDA. That goes directly. It's piped into our brains here as announcers.
Taylor Long, using the talk2WFTDA hashtag, says Dr. Octopushy is my new favorite derby name.
Fanny Pack-a-Punch, wearing number 750, jamming Fort Carolina against Hurricane Jackie. Jackie on the right side. Jackie's been a lot of risk and reward, but when she's out there, it is exciting. When she can put it in the positive direction, she already has 20 points.
We've got a rogue kneecap sitting between the pivot and jammer line as Hurricane Jackie picks up a grand slam for Blue Ridge.
She of the 4 penalties in the first period category, and no score at the end for either team. 184-255. Blue Ridge continues to lead. Blue Ridge, number 7 seed there in this tournament. They're 55th ranked in the universe, a 7-3 record in the regular season. They're from Asheville, North Carolina. Timeout called by Carolina.
It's a good timeout, Danny Mack. You know, you finished the first half well. You were able to force 2 penalties on the Blue Ridge jammers, Hurricane Jackie. You've unfortunately started the first 5 jams of the second half, only getting lead in lead number 1, and you still got outscored 8-9 in that one jam. So far everything's still coming up. Millhouse for Blue Ridge, if you know the Simpsons reference. But a good timeout. Again, it's only Carolina's first used timeout. Developed almost a 100-point deficit going into halftime, didn't use any timeouts in the first period. And what I kind of like to see, if Carolina is experimenting with jammers, I spoke with JoJo Gadget after Carolina came to Columbus a couple months ago. JoJo was originally brought in and jammed for Carolina. It got to where the point where it was, she became a stalwart in the blocking core, and they would really be affected if she was taken out. But I would actually really like to see what JoJo could possibly do. If you're going to do it, you know, there's still 22 minutes left and you're down 130, but, you know, see what you got for the rest of this tournament. If Jammer all of a sudden starts having difficulties, see what JoJo can do for you.
That's Andrew Marone. He hails from Ohio. Always a coach, sometimes an announcer. And in this case, he is delighting us with his stylings in Wichita, the Sports Forum Division II playoff action, International WFTDA playoffs. Lead Jammer, Blue Ridge. They're continuing to try to pile it on at 184-55.
Carolina has jammed Ginger Clobbers 3 times this period. Ava Gore is the only skater for Carolina with a positive differential when it comes to jamming for Carolina. I'm surprised we haven't seen Ava Gore into this game more.
Track cut for Clobbers.
That won't help.
And a nice hop, skip, and a jump to get through the end of that pack. Great athleticism by Dr. Octopushy. The transfer came over from Grand Raggedy, played for Wasatch as well. Came in about a little less than a year ago to play for this Blue Ridge team and has been an unbelievable infusion of offense.
Grand Raggedy, Pushy's former team, will be playing next weekend, I believe, in Lansing.
Yeah,
I think.
I believe you're right. Clobber's back on the floor. Full strength, 5-on-5.
Carolina had gotten out. That was Clobbers. She stashed the helmet cover before drawing the penalty. Came out and immediately returned the helmet cover to her head and got through to force the call off.
And what I liked about Blue Ridge on that previous jam, on the second scoring pass, they were able to knock out a Carolina blocker. And then when that blocker stepped back on the track, Blue Ridge collapsed right back down on that blocker, forming a new pack 20 feet away from where the jammer was. Foremost blockers for Carolina were out of play. Boom, easy peasy, 5 points.
20 minutes or thereabouts remaining in this one with Blue Ridge 199, Carolina 55. Jammers for Blue Ridge is Lady Ryder. For Carolina is Aurora Thunder. Ryder draws a track cut right away. 10 seconds into that jam. Let's see what Thunder can do with it. Aurora Thunder just got out. Lead jammer for Carolina.
Aurora Thunder now. 1 for 3, jamming for Carolina, getting lead, has yet to score points, though, with a -4 differential here. So we'll see if Thunder can get some points on the board for Carolina. We'll see how they play this. They're actually going to let this run as Ryder is still on her initial pass. I like the decision of keeping this one going.
And Lady Ryder comes out of the penalty box and tiptoes on the outside of the track. She is in scoring position.
Great job by Blue Ridge's defense, though. Now scoring points for Blue Ridge, and it almost looks like Aurora Thunder is going to get outscored here with lead designation. Calling it off now, 4 points. Yes, she did get outscored, Danny Mack.
AT, probably a little bit frustrated by that one, just got swallowed up. Woman handled in the middle of the pack the entire jam.
Fanny Pack-a-Punch taking the fast girl start line, going against Tractor Taylor.
204 for Blue Ridge, 59 for Carolina.
McGilla Gorilla from St. Louis, Hoosiers reference, and now the Simpsons. My kind of derby analysis. We keep it simple, Gil. Keep it simple.
That's the in-depth reporting and announcing you get on WFTDA.TV. Thanks for joining us. That's Andrew Marone. I'm Danny Mack. On WFTDA.TV, the free audio stream or the very, very affordable TV stream, live video on your phone, your computer, wherever you want to watch it. Punch takes lead jammer for Carolina. This is a key opportunity with 18 minutes remaining.
It's their second lead designation in a row here after going lead jammerless for 5 jams.
Fanny Pack-a-Bunch calls it off from her knees, takes 5 on the way.
Thank you to Rydell Skates, the innovative leader in the roller skating industry for over 70 years. Make your skates your own with custom colored, handcrafted Color Lab boots by Rydell Skates. Powerdyne changing the game again with the newly redesigned Arius Platinum. Arius Platinum Performance, performance redefined. Powerdyne.
The video coverage, live video coverage from Wichita, and for any tournament, $12.99 gets you the entire weekend. $75, on the other hand, gets you every single moment of the international playoffs and championship. Lead jammer for Blue Ridge. They're up 204-64, a 140-point lead. Carolina seemingly lost track of the jammer as they were clustered around the inside of the track, and the opposing jammer, Blue Ridge, just blew right past them on the outside, taking 5 points. Carolina gets a goose egg on that one.
Steel City's Allie McKill using the Talk to WFTDA handle. Carolina needs decisiveness in their transition game. Hesitation deciding between offensive for jammer or defensive in their walls is costing them. And that's exactly what we've kind of been talking about, Danny Mack. You know, when they're set, but they're able to get blown apart relatively easy here by Blue Ridge. Commit, 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 commit.
Ginger Clobbers jamming for Carolina. Dr. Octopushy going for Blue Ridge. Blue Ridge on the right side. Carolina, again, just swallowing up the jammer, attempting to isolate them, keep them at bay before they can get out and do those quick footwork things that Dr. Octopushy likes to do, as you see in the open floor.
Multiplayer block on JoJo Gadget now leaves their skaters for Columbia. A skater short lead designation going to Ginger Clobbers, calling the jam off. Oh, didn't need to, as as I believe Pushy was still on her initial pass.
Yeah, Dr. Octopushy was still in the pack, still swallowed up by Carolina. After a while, it almost kind of becomes a force of habit.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, the way Dr. Octopushy has dominated lead jammer, though it's fallen off here in the second period, you gotta have the head on a swivel and realize situationally what's happening.
Well, that too, and when we've seen either team get lead, it's been boom, it's been by the pivot line, Danny Mac. These attainments have been coming very quickly off the jam start whistle. So, you know, that jam lasted about 35, 40 seconds. And, you know, maybe Ginger Clobbers just thought, oh, man, I finally got through and I got lead. I better call it, because maybe she just assumed that it was already been Pushy was already on a scoring pass. But, you know, we talked about Ava Gore, the only skater with positive differential right now for Carolina. That's dropped to 7, but she still is on the positive side of things. She actually did get to jam a couple jams ago, was outscored 5-0. But the good news is she was able to get out of the pack and kind of stop those double-digit jams. 7 double-digit jams right now for Blue Ridge skaters.
Blue Ridge, a 145-point lead. The WFTDA would like to thank our hosts, the ICT Roller Girls, also Triple Eight, and Bruised Skate Noose, partnering to bring you WFTDA.TV.
Skaters are away at the Fast Girls start line. Multiplayer block to Q for Carolina. Lead designation going to Ryder.
Very quick on the draw. 10 seconds to get in and out of the pack.
Oh.
Track cut called on Carolina. Blue Ridge cruising. 5 points for Ryder. The Ish perhaps took a little reasonable umbrage with that call, taking another 5 points as Blue Ridge, and the Ish can just sit in the penalty box and watch it happen.
And not only that, but Ryder only had one Carolina defender to deal with, as they had a full penalty box with one in the queue. So now two skaters out there for Carolina. Oh, and she had a nice little toe hop step there coming out of turn two.
Couple of jumps over the inside part of the track. Didn't land them, and she knew it. So immediately Ryder put on reverse, or put on the C-stop, and decided to head backwards and reset. Full strength for Carolina. Ryder already, that's another 5 points. So that's 15 points in this jam.
Isherin out of bounds at turn three. She comes back in behind the Blue Ridge contingency. Q looking for a star pass. Danny Mack finally gets it, but she is also right in front of Coma Inducer. Good luck.
This one has been at times borderline out of control in terms of scoring for Blue Ridge. They have scored at will. 5 more points for Blue Ridge, 19 total in that jam for Ryder.
Electrocution celebrating. She got 2 points there at the end of the jam. She says she got 3, but only going to be awarded 2 points for Carolina's cue there. It almost looked like Blue Ridge thought they were going to call that jam off a few seconds prior to that, but a late call-off allowing Q to score for Carolina, 228-66.
With that 19-pointer for Lady Ryder, she becomes the game's leading scorer. 96 points, an 84-point plus differential for Blue Ridge when Lady Ryder is out there. She has performed exceedingly well in this second period. Lead jammer for Carolina. It's go time. 13 minutes. Mixing it up. There's Ava Gore, as we mentioned, has been very effective when she's been out there. 19 points, lead, second place behind Clobbers for Carolina scorers, but 7 plus.
Oh, and we have a blocking to the back penalty on tracks, Tractor Taylor. So she'll be hitching her wagon to the 888 penalty box, as she will sit for 30 seconds. And that, right now, Danny Mack, as we kind of talk a little bit of strategy, you find yourself down this gap with 12 and a half minutes remaining. Now is the time, if you get lead in Carolina, you need to run two-minute jams, because now you just need to score points. And that point differential, you're talking percentage of points now. Captain Lou talks about it all the time up in Canada. You know, what you need to do is you're starting to start, as that blowout starts to get a little worse, you know, you get lead, go ahead and run 2 minutes. It's okay. 4 points put on the board there, though, by Ava Gore.
Gore, it's hard to tell if there was bloodshed on that play from the makeup, but she's really wiping perhaps a bloody lip or something of that nature, took a shot at the end and was in a great deal of discomfort at the end of play. That's Andrew Marone telling you about the strategy behind roller derby. He tells this from experience as Ohio Roller Girls head coach and joining us on WFTDA.TV all weekend.
Well, what I do know is official reviews, and we've got one right now here being called, I believe, by Blue Ridge. We don't know yet. There's no ref microphones here, so we're going to wait until we hear from our referee liaison, Searson. Makes his way back to the Zebra Brigade. But if you look at penalties, and we kind of talk about Carolina, you know, for years their defense has been strong, Danny Mack, but over the past couple of years, and you've seen it why they haven't been in playoffs, is because they're jamming. They haven't had that familiar, stable jamming core that they're used to having in the pack, or that they're used to having in the past, and it shows in their statistics. They've got 7.33 jammer penalties per bout. That's right at the top. I believe they're second highest out of all the teams that are here at Wichita, thanks to Dylan Powell for the stats, and for the Sports Information Committee here with the WFTDA. But you know, right now they're sitting on 9, so they're already ahead of schedule. They've still got 12 to go. Their defense hasn't been able to stop the Blue Ridge's offense for their own jammers. So really it's kind of almost, I don't want to call it a free skate yet for Blue Ridge jammers when it comes to power jams, but if Carolina has any desire to continue to score here in the second half, they need to keep their jammers out of the box, even if it means, you know, I'm not sure what I did, let me just reset anyway. You know, I always tell my skaters, you know, if you don't know, if you're unsure, or if you don't hear me yell that you're good, come back and drop in behind everybody. You know, there's no risk in doing, especially now with teams getting rid of the passive offense and going straight offense for their jammers, helping out their jammers, showing some love for their jammers. You know, we can get 15, 20, 25 points on these power jams again.
And Blue Ridge leading 228-70. We have 12 minutes, an official review going on. Andrew Marone trying to figure out what that's all about, getting the information from the official.
Well, Blue Ridge went to get the back block on jammer tracks taken away. The will not, they said, we're done. Jammer penalty will stand.
All righty. Clobbers to the line, trying to capitalize with a power jam. Carolina has to score immediately. 12 minutes and ticking in this bout.
Nice step there on the inside, able to get horizontal there and toe step up the inside of turn 4.
Blue Ridge returns to nearly full strength. They will be full strength here in a few ticks.
And if I'm Carolina, even though the jammer for Blue Ridge is on her initial pass now, two skaters to beat for Blue Ridge's jammer, I would run this jam long. See what you got. Go ahead and try. Trex obviously just went to the penalty box. If you can get another penalty on her, hey, great. Oh, unfortunately, this jam is going to go 2 minutes, but
yep,
it's not for all the right reasons, Danny Mack, as Ginger Clobbers makes her way to the penalty box for a blocking to the back penalty.
Power jam for Blue Ridge.
Number 10.
Lady Ryder. As Carolina will line up and staunchly hold Lady Ryder back. Carolina, one player to left to try to go after Ryder, and that player engaged too far. She will draw a penalty. And that's the pivot. That is electrocution. Electra out of the engagement zone, and we'll have to sit a while to think about that one. 5 more points for Blue Ridge. 10 minutes, 30 seconds to go. Carrie heads to the box for Carolina. A 5-3 skater advantage for Blue Ridge.
Looks like possibly JoJo Gadget can be called for an out of play penalty there at the front of the pack, as she was the one that knocked tracks out of bounds on the back straightaway. And again, using the screen of black Blue Ridge jerseys goes Tractor Taylor for 4 additional points.
And Blue Ridge milking the clock away, 242-77. Carolina in the playoffs due to a couple of teams not accepting invitations. Grand Raggedy, the 61 seed, also playing because of that. So Carolina and Grand Raggedy kind of not finishing in the top 60, but
are making their playoff appearances this year.
I'd like to thank Adam Skates, Color Falcon Plates, and Color Q4 Boots. Check out all the colorful new goods from Adam Skates. Also, while you're there, check out the new Pilot Plate in 7 stunning colors.
Hurricane Jackie jamming for Blue Ridge. She will start about 5 steps back. And Ava Gore going for Carolina. Gore has been in the jammer rotation much of the season, but has finished fourth in the regular season. In terms of scoring, tonight has been a different story. Ava Gore has the second most points of any Carolina jammer, but has been really effective when on there, and of course when not drawing penalties.
Well, Carolina in the second half, after that timeout, they've done a good job of obtaining lead designation, actually getting 5 of the last 7. Unfortunately, with those 2 power jams to Blue Ridge they've given them, they've been outscored 38-16.
Carolina is out and in scoring position. Blue Ridge sensing the Carolina jammer coming up on the rear of the pack. That is a good call off by Hurricane Jackie. Not only got all the points she could possibly receive, but also had the awareness to stop the play before Carolina might be able to sneak in there.
A lot of standout players right now for both these squads, especially for Blue Ridge here as they continue to increase on their lead. Maybe a possible MVP at the end of this weekend. Fast Girl Skates, they are proud to sponsor the 2016 WFTDA Tournament MVPs. We might be seeing one in this game right now, Danny Mack.
Blue Ridge, 250 points. Carolina, 77 points. The Battle of North Carolina. Dr. Octopushy, lead jammer. Doc Ox had leads 6 times out of the 9 jams she's been on the track.
Right now at this point, Pushy is just trying to catch Lady Ryder for high point score in this contest. Dr. Octopushy picking up those 4 is going to put her at 92, right behind Lady Ryder. Ryder with 96 in this contest. And right, speaking of Lady Ryder, out on the track right now.
As we look ahead, Blue Ridge in command with about 7.5 minutes. Assuming they are victorious in this one, they will move on to play Houston, and that happens this afternoon. The number 2 seed Houston versus the winner of this one at 4 p.m. And the loser will move on, or will head down to the consolation bracket. In order to play beyond this venue, you have to win the first day.
Mm-hmm.
That's just how it is.
Oh, and Blue Ridge here employing a little bit of strategy here. DeAntichrist jamming for the first time for Carolina. Lady Ryder got out of the pack, looked at her coach. Coach says, no, keep going. This isn't a jammer for Carolina. So they're going to run this a little long here, but DeAntichrist kind of making Blue Ridge pay here. And this is the advantage of switching up jammers here to a more physical person with the jammer star. I kind of wanted to see JoJo Gadget, but DeAntichrist is doing a great job now. 2 scoring passes for DeAntichrist.
Right. 4 more on this one. Carolina still trails 262-85. Got to mix it up when you get late in the game like this and perhaps get a spark from unusual places.
Jam gets called off as we thank RollerCon, Spank Alley, and Rollline for helping with this postseason's sponsorship plans.
DeAntichrist has only 8 points in the regular season.
Well, she got 11 in that previous jam, so
already
killing
out,
it.
Already outdoing herself.
She just underachieved, Danny Mack.
Under 6 minutes to go in this one. 266-88, Blue Ridge over Carolina. Carolina, they are donning white. Blue Ridge donning black. If you're just joining us, this is the opening game of the Division II playoffs, and actually the opening game of the entire international WFTDA playoff season. The road to the Hydra starts in Wichita. Blue Ridge, 4 points. Tractor Taylor. 5 minutes, 12 seconds remaining. Looking ahead as well, the next bout coming at you is Boulder County Bombers versus Chicago Outfit Roller Derby. That's at noon. And those times are all Central Daylight Time. So wherever you are in the universe, that is so noon Central will be Boulder County versus Chicago Outfit Roller Derby, the 8-9 game.
Triple A penalty box empty right now. Well, no, now it's going to be filled, but it's going to be 155, the jammer, Hurricane Jackie, and that's going to be Jackie's fifth penalty with 4.5 minutes remaining in this contest. It was Jackie, Hurry, and can't see who it is, Ginger Clobbers. They were the ones on the fast girl start line.
Blue Ridge trying to tamp this penalty down and escape unscored. Carolina's jammer, the ish, removes the helmet cover and has passed it off to her, or rather, ish received it, but it was Ginger Clobbers that removed the helmet cover. Clobbers now out there as a blocker, trying to go at the Blue Ridge jammer, who has returned to the track. And a solid penalty kill again by Blue Ridge. There is no active jammer in place for Carolina at the moment.
Well, still on her, because it was the star pass.
Yep, and that was unsuccessful. Now Carolina's pushed their pivot through, and that pivot becomes a jammer. That's the ish.
I kind of disagree with the star pass here, Danny Mack, and I'll tell you why. Lead designation was still open for Ginger Clobber, so rather than getting lead, now we're going to go the full 2 minutes, with which has about 30 seconds remaining on it, and now you've got the ish taking the star for Carolina. 0-for-4 jamming, only has 15 points and 2 box trips.
The clock is Blue Ridge's friend at this point. 20 seconds left on the jam. You'd expect them to use a heck of a lot of that, if not all, to try to get below 3 minutes.
And Ginger Clobbers is very gingerly laying on the outside of turn four, holding the small of her back. So only 3 blockers on the track right now for Carolina. Maybe that's why she passed it. I don't know. I don't know when the injury occurred, but Clobbers still on one knee at turn four.
Clobbers in a lot of pain. Officials coming around to check her out. And an official timeout called by Chopsaw. 284 to 94, Blue Ridge over Carolina. 2.5 minutes remaining in this one.
You know, we kind of see the penalty trouble starting to sneak up and bite Carolina here. Getting outscored in the second half, 142 to 45, well over their season average for blocking. For jamming penalties. We're unfortunately able to see the. There it is, whiteboard. Carolina Roller Girls skaters with 4 penalties. Well, Grim Carey has 6, and then skaters with 4 are Ginger Clobbers, JoJo Gadget, Crank Dat, Electrocution, and DeAntichrist, all with 4 penalties. On the other side, for Blue Ridge, the only jammer in any kind of trouble right now is Hurricane Jackie. She's got 5. The next closest person is Brutal with 3. Everyone else either has 1, 2, or 0.
We'd like to thank S1 Helmets. The S1 Lifer Helmet is the best fitting and safest helmet for roller derby. Get a lifer, be a lifer. S1 makes the best helmets and pads for derby. S1 is part of my uniform. S1helmets.com.
35 penalties right now for Carolina Roller Girls. Their blockers only average about 30.78 per bout, so ahead of schedule on that one as well for Carolina.
Dr. Octopushy jamming for Blue Ridge. DeAntichrist going for Carolina.
I like the variety here for Carolina, as it looks like Pushy has now been designated lead.
And so it goes. Team in black trying to run this one out. 2:08 on the jam clock. Or rather on the game clock, the jam clock at 1.5 minutes. About 30 seconds apart from each other. 4 points for Blue Ridge.
We will have an empty 888 penalty box to start this next jam. So it'll be an all skate here, as we see taking the fast girl skate start line, Ava Gore and Lady Ryder.
nearing the end of this one. 1 minute and 36 seconds left on the clock. As soon as that ticks away, the jam clock is what becomes the clock of record, so pay attention to that one. And there it goes.
Ryder over 108 points in today's contest. 8 of 10, actually now make it 9 of 11 when it comes to jamming. And a penalty, Danny Mac, to Carolina's jammer, Ava Gore.
And you see the signal from the Blue Ridge bench. Keep on skating. Blue Ridge going to take this lead and skate into the next round. 5 more points, under a minute to go on the game clock.
Houston, I hope you're paying attention, because this 7-3 Asheville team is for real.
Blue Ridge has done it before, shaken some plans in the playoffs, and they're looking to do it yet again. 7 seed for this one. Going to wrap up this victory against the 10 seed Carolina.
25 seconds left on the game clock. We'll see if Blue Ridge is content to just run this clock here. Still on her initial pass is Ava Gore, so no hurry at this point to call this jam off, Danny Mac.
Ryder with 13 seconds left in the bout.
Lady Ryder now with 123 points for the contest.
Lady Ryder, nice apex hop on the inside. And the bout clock has expired. Lady Ryder can stop it at any point with 25 seconds left on the jam clock.
I believe that call got called off because the pivot for Carolina, Aurora Thunder, went down holding her head, and she has actually crawled from the midway point of turns 3 and 4, has crawled back to her own bench. Medic now coming out, and Medic is dealing now with 2 people as we have Aurora Thunder, and it looks like, I can't see who's laying on the track right here. I can't tell if that's JoJo or if that's Q. It's not JoJo. I see the red helmet.
Well, the whistle came after the whistle came after the bout clock had already expired. So I think timing-wise, this one is in the books, and they do blow the final whistle. So Blue Ridge continues on. 309 to 94, the final score, as they take their victory lap. And they are advancing, the team from Asheville, North Carolina, moving on as a 7 seed. They will face a very, very tough number 2 seeded Houston. They will play later this afternoon at 4 o'clock, and they have got their work cut out for them in that one. But that's a heck of a nice start for Blue Ridge, a comfortable lead the entire bout. They led wire to wire, and they really won in the kind of ways you want to see, getting lead jammer, the real kind of nuts and bolts of how you want to put together a victory. They put those all together, as now we see Carolina going around the track.
What Blue Ridge did really well was they spread things out. Lady Ryder was their third leading scorer coming into this season, averaging 449 points, averaging about 45 per bout, Danny Mac. Today she killed it. 129 points for Lady Ryder, 96 points for Dr. Octopushy, 52 points for Hurricane Jackie. Not too bad considering she spent 5 jams in the penalty box as a jammer. With 32 points was Tractor Taylor, a nice little fourth insert there to give their jammers a little bit of a break. But that was a complete team win for the Blue Ridge Roller Girls out of Asheville. And right now they've got bragging rights in the state of North Carolina. Carolina needs to go back to the locker room and really kind of discuss some things. Do we want to play defense? Do we want to play offense? Who's going to be in charge of calling that switch? You know, the transition game needs to be on point for these squads, especially in the playoffs and the postseason. You know, Carolina, sometimes there was a little discord about what we're going to do and when we're going to do it. That jammer's out, boom. You need to start playing offense for your jammer and get them through, especially, you know, if they're having trouble, like obviously the Carolina Roller Girl jammers did. Now all after that last Ava Gore jam, all jammers, all 7 of them, Aurora Thunder, Ava Gore, D'Antichrist, Fanny Pack-a-Punch, Clobbers, Grim Carry, and the Ish, all with negative differentials. As a coach, you hope for 1 or 2 standouts, but unfortunately just wasn't in the cards right now for Carolina. They played hard. I can't fault them for that. They're still a great team, but Blue Ridge, Blue Ridge looks really good.
They do. They look tight. They had their ish together. Blue Ridge will advance to play Houston. That game, again, 4 o'clock. So not only do they have to win a tough one, they've got to turn around and in a matter of hours play the number 2 seed in this tournament. Carolina, by virtue of the loss, will play tomorrow. They'll get the rest of the day off because of that. They'll play tomorrow at noon in the loser of Game 6, which is Brandywine Roller Derby, and Kansas City Roller Warriors, the 5-4 bout coming up. That one will be at 8 o'clock tonight. That's kind of the marquee bout this evening. So that's who Carolina will face, the loser of that. And as you look ahead, I mean, Blue Ridge has at that 7 seed one of the toughest rows to hoe, having to then go on to that 2 seed, Houston. And you know a little bit about Houston. That's, a very potent offensive team, something that Blue Ridge is going to have to play out of their minds in order to be in that one and try to emerge victorious.
And if you like fundamental derby, Blue Ridge versus Houston, offense to defense transition, defense to offense transition, use of star pass now for Houston. Oh, it's going to be a technically awesome game. But up next, we've got Boulder County going up against the Chicago Outfit Roller Derby. For Danny Mack, I'm Andrew Marone, and this has been Blue Ridge versus Carolina. Thank you for watching WFTDA TV.